Student friends, myself Dr. Archana Pandey, and today I have come up with a new topic that is for the estimation of a reducing sugar. Now, the first question may arise to your mind, like what is a reducing sugar? So I'll be discussing it ahead in this video. And for this detection of the method that can be used for what we can say reducing sugar, there are two different methods which can be used. One is using a DNS agent, that is 3,5-dinitrosalicylic acid, and the other one is the phenol sulfuric acid method. And today in this video, I'll be just discussing one technique, that is how to estimate the concentration of a reducing sugar in using the 3,5-dinitrosalicylic acid, or we can say that is DNS method. First of all, we will discuss like what is a carbohydrate. You might have also studied in the basics, like the carbohydrate, we know that it is the abundant class of the compounds which are being used by most of the living organisms, and that we know it is the instant source of energy because it boosts our metabolism, help in growing up, building our what we can say the metabolic process, enhances it, and it has been used by both plants as well as the animals. Now, they can also be used for the transport of the compounds, which we ideally call it as energy currency of cell. What you heard is right, that is ATP. They are also involved in making of ATP, which indirectly give us the energy, which helps in boosting our metabolism. Now, we know that carbohydrates, they are being classified into different categories, that we call it as monosaccharide, disaccharides and polysaccharides. So what are monosaccharides? They are nothing but they are the simplest form of the sugars, which are ideally water soluble, and they are crystalline solids like what we use in our day-to-day life, like your glucose, your fructose, galactose. Then second class comes, that is your disaccharides, which is being formed by the combination of two monosaccharides. I mean, like one monosaccharide and second, when they combine, they will together form a two molecule compound, which is called as a disaccharide. That is, the example is your sucrose and lactose. And the third classification is your polysaccharides, which is being formed by forming a chain of monosaccharides, like your starch or glycogen or cellulose. When many monosaccharides are joined by the, what we can say, the glycosidic linkage, whether it is 1 and 3 or 5 and bonds, right? So that leads to the polysaccharides. Today we'll discuss what is the principle, what are the requirements and the procedures, and how we can go for the detection, or we can say how to estimate the concentration of the reducing sugar. So basically, principle starts with we are using a compound, that is 3,5-dinitrosalicylic acid, which is being widely used in what we can say the biochemistry field for the estimation of reducing sugar. I also told earlier, like what is bioreducing sugar? We know that sugars, they have two basic groups, that is C double bond O, which is called as your carbonyl group, and the other one is your CHO group, that is your aldehyde group. So basically what happens when the sugar will be having your C double bond O, that is your carboxyl group, that will be detected. Okay, so that is called as your, what we can say, the reducing sugar. So this involves what we can say the oxidation of the aldehyde functional group. Like glucose is having the aldehyde group, that is the CHO. I'll display the structure also, what the glucose is having. Like if you can see the first carbon, they have CHO group, that is the aldehyde group. And the ketone group, that is C double bond O, which is present in the fructose. So you can see in the image also. Now during this reaction, when we are using a DNSA, that is 3-nitro, what we can say 3,5-dinitrosalicylic acid, which is being under in an alkaline condition, they get reduced to a colored compound, which is somewhat reddish brown in color. And we will take the OD, what we call it as an optical density, we're using the spectrophotometer at 540 nanometers. So basically, what are the different requirements? So there are few chemicals we'll be needing it. I'll be mentioning their composition, like how we can prepare them in the, what we can say, the description box. The first compound what we'll be needing is a sodium potassium tartrate, that is going to give the alkaline condition to our mixture. Then we'll be needing a 3,5-dinitro solution, that is your 3,5-dinitrosalicylic acid, which in short we can call it as a DNS. Then we need a 2 molar of NaOH and your standard sugar solution, right? We'll be needing all of these compounds. Now I'll be showing you an image or a table that will keep it little bit what we can say easier to you, like how you can prepare your tubes. So we'll be needing total of 8 test tubes, out of which you will be having 1 as a blank and 7 as your test samples, or you can say your standards. So what concentration we are trying to maintain, that will be from 0 to 200 microgram per ml. So for, suppose you are taking a blank, it means the blank will not have any sugar, but from 1 till 6, okay, or till 5, you are taking around 40, 80, then 120, 160, 200 micrograms of your sugar. Now you have to, what we can say, we have to make it a equal volume. Like suppose one tube is having 40, the other one is having directly 200. So there is a difference or a gap of 160 microliter. So in order to nullify that gap, we will make up a final volume till 1, or you can say you can go it for 200 microliters in all the tubes. Now we'll be adding the DNS solution in all the tubes, that is 0.5 ml in all of the tubes. Then we will keep it in a boiling water bath. Boiling water bath means the water should be boiling. It should not be like that you have kept it on a gas and you're directly immersing your tube and let that water to boil. No, you have to keep the water prior. When it is bubbling, then only you have to keep your tubes for 5 to 10 minutes and then allow it to cool at a room temperature, and then you will take the OD at 540 nanometers. After that, against the blank, you have to set the zero against using the blank, and then you will take the OD of your standards as well as your unknown. Now here I'll share the graph with you also how the standards can be plotted, that is your absorbance versus the glucose concentration. A straight line should be there if you have done it properly, without any error, without handling errors, or without any mistakes. So you'll get a straight graph, and then using that graph you will be able to trace the what we can say the concentration of your unknown sample. So this is how the DNS method can be performed using the standard calibration curve, you can say, or the DNS by for the reducing sugar. I hope you like the video, and if you have any query during using this method, you can ask me in the comment section box. I'll be happy to answer you. And if you have not yet subscribed to my channel, do subscribe it. Hit the like button if you have liked it, and share among the students' friends. Still then, stay tuned and stay safe. Thank you so much for watching.